Okay, before things get too complicated, it's time we clear up something that could cause us trouble later, maybe causing some of you some stress if you have any experience with chromosomes before. This picture that you saw earlier is in fact a real picture of human chromosomes from a cell. Let's focus in on this pair of chromosomes here. They sort of look like big X's, don't they? If I were to try to draw them in cartoon form, this is how I would probably try to represent them. And although this is an accurate representation of what you see here, in reality, this type of chromosome is called a duplicated chromosome. It's called a duplicated chromosome because of each side of the X is actually identical to the other side. And we refer to each of these sides as chromatids. In fact, because they're so identical, we refer to them as sister chromatids. This chromosome over here also has sister chromatids. So we have one pair of chromosomes, one pair of X's, and they each are composed of sister chromatids, which are duplicated strands of each other. However, most of the time, chromosomes look like this instead. They don't look like an X, they're just one linear molecule. We call this a non-duplicated chromosome. This is what the pair typically looks like in a cell. Remember, linear chromosomes are just double-stranded DNA in one really long molecule, wrapped up in histone proteins into a higher order structure that looks like the chromosome we're used to seeing. But after duplication, the double-stranded DNA is now copied, and now there are two copies, two double-stranded molecules of DNA, and they're joined together in the middle here. And this is what makes them look like these big X's over here. And because they're genetically identical, we call these sister chromatids here within this X. That's what the sister chromatids are. But we still call the linear non-duplicated chromosome a chromosome, and we call the duplicated version with sister chromatids a chromosome. It's still a chromosome structure. The reason most pictures you've seen of chromosomes look like this is because this is when they're most condensed and easy to see. As you can imagine, DNA is like a big loose string that's really long inside a cell, and it's normally sort of loosey-goosey hanging out. But when a cell divides, it has to organize and get everything together and choreograph to separate. And so it condenses into these beautiful organized structures that make it easy for us to see. So a scientist will wait until a cell gets to this point, and then it opens the cell up to see the chromosome. And because we're at this stage after the DNA's been duplicated, they look like this X structure, but they can also look like this non-X or just linear structure. Now, I want you to tell me, of the following four groupings of chromosomes, which of the following represents four chromosomes, either duplicated or non-duplicated? Pick which ones represent four chromosomes. There can be multiple answers, or there may not, so I want you to check all the boxes that you think apply.